Well, hello there, ye faithful few, and welcome back to DMS Adventures, where sometimes the vids are all about the kids. In today's video, I'm going to be sharing with you 7 tips when backpacking with kids that I have gathered through our adventures so far. So let's get right to it. Tip number 1, like our video from last week sang about, you have got to have patience. Not just a little, a lot. And if you are getting into backpacking and you have kids already, which would be one of the only reasons you'd be watching this video, you already know when it comes to kids, you just need patience. So that becomes even more true, in my opinion, when you are trying to take them out into the backcountry. So I mean, one of the most obvious things to consider is, like in the Rugged Mountain Mister's case, I mean, he's taken 2.5-3 steps for every step I take. So it's just gonna take him longer. He just can't move quite as fast. And that's gonna be the case with most kids. So first, you just need patience in how quickly you're moving down the trail. Then secondly, you know, you really kind of need to have that stop and smell the roses attitude, and almost literally, maybe not roses, but wildflowers. We've got to stop and check out every single bug that we find that doesn't fly away quickly. Different kinds of caterpillars. We'll chase some animals into the woods, whatever it may be. You just need to have patience as they're exploring the outdoors for the first time, and really want them to enjoy that aspect of it. So even though you've got kind of a time frame in your mind about how quickly you need to be moving along to get to point A, B, or C, take a deep breath and just remember, kids, all of this is super exciting, and that's the way you want it. So take the time, stop, smell the roses, investigate everything that they find interesting. Tip number 2 really helps out with tip number 1, and that is planning. The better you've planned your trip out, the more time you know you have for things, and the more patient you can be. So when I'm planning an adventure with the kids, I do have a end goal in mind. However, you also need to check your trail out, check the campsites out, and be sure that you have some additional bailout points along the way, or you need to have additional places to camp in mind if you don't actually get to make it to your end goal. I know on our 5th ever backpacking endeavor, when it was just myself and Rugged Mountain Mister, I did have to alter our trail plans. I wanted to make it all the way to the ladders, but we were just running out of daylight and we weren't gonna make it. No big deal. But I knew it ahead of time that I could cut the trail short at that given point that we were at. Then in planning, you also need to be considering what they're taking, how much extra food you need, how much water you're gonna bring, and then how much of that you're gonna have them carry. And that brings us to tip number 3, and that is pack weights. I haven't figured out these are all P's yet. Pretty cool. I spent some time on that. So for pack weights, I found a general rule of thumb is you want to keep their pack weight 10 to 15% of their body weight. Now, 15% of my body weight is around 30 pounds, and I don't particularly like carrying 30 pounds. I'd prefer to get that down a little bit. Then when you get to Rugged Mountain Mister, he's at about 40 pounds. So you're looking at trying to keep his pack weight around 6 pounds. Well, with his gear, his sleeping bag is 2 pounds, his backpack itself is 2 pounds, and his sleeping mat is 1 pound. So you got 5 pounds right there. And we typically will carry a poncho for him, and he always wants to bring Ray or Elsa or some toys. So he gets up to 6 pounds pretty quick, and that's pretty much all that I have him carry. Then with Rugged Mountain Sister, she doesn't particularly like carrying 15%. I try and keep her to 10%, which is very difficult. She's around 80 pounds, so trying to keep her in the 10-pound range is what I usually try and do. And just when you're keeping those pack weights down for them, it just makes the whole experience better for them. And as they get older, can start adding some more weight. And as they get used to it and they get their trail legs, then you can be adding some more weight to what they carry. So you know what that means? In the meantime, you're gonna be carrying a little more weight in order to be bringing all the things that you need for your adventure. Tip number 4 is to bring plenty of snacks. And not just snacks for snack's sake, but things that you wouldn't normally get. We will get like those freeze-dried ice cream sandwiches. They love those. I'll let them bring all kinds of candy. One of the things that we like to do is go to like a health food store where they have the bins of granola and different kinds of candies. And we'll go through and we'll just pick out one small scoop of each thing and just throw them into bags and then just make a snack bag out of those types of things. And theirs are typically made up of gummy bears, gummy worms. But main point of the tip is let them bring things, snacks, things to eat that you may not normally let them at home. And that just makes the adventure just that much more exciting. Tip number 5, and kind of stretching the keeping with the peas thing, is let them bring a posh item, otherwise known as a luxury item. We did a whole video on that. I'll link that right up here. And like Rugamountain Mister, he loves to bring his puppies, either Elsa or Ray. Rugamountain Sister likes to bring different kinds of toys. She likes to bring flip-flops for being able to just get in and out of the tent easy. Whatever it is, just try to put a little more weight of the necessities on yourself so that they can be carrying their fun items that, again, just make the adventure a little more enjoyable for them. Tip number 6 is pauses, aka breaks. You need to take a lot of breaks. You need to have that in your tip 2 planning. Just plan in a lot of breaks. Sometimes we'll try and hike for like 30 minutes straight, and then we'll stop to take a 10-minute break. 30 minutes, 10 minutes. Makes things take longer, but anytime you can give them a chance to rest their shoulders or back after keeping their pack weight down, again, just makes it more adventurous. They can stop. Usually what I'll do is I'll try and set up a couple of shots while we're waiting just to be able to vlog some more information or some more shots while we're taking that break and while they are being able to rest themselves so that we can get back on the trail and have another good 30-minute run or whatever it may be for you. And the last tip, number 7, is something that can be pretty difficult for some. Others don't have any problem with it at all. It can be a challenge for me, and that is positivity. You got to keep their spirits up, tell them that they're doing great, tell them that we're getting close, or we're getting close to our next break. Whatever it may be, just need to keep the positivity going, help keep their attention maybe on something other than how heavy their pack is or how tired they are. Point out things out in nature, point out things in creation. Point out things to them that can keep their minds off of what may be difficult about the trip and be focusing them on what is awesome about the trip. Like the fact that you're even out there can be an amazing thing. Remind them when they get to camp how they can pull out their luxury items and enjoy it. Stop and let them have some of that candy that we let them have in tip number 4. Anything we can do just to keep their spirits up, keep them happy. And I'll tell you what, especially with the Rugamountain Mister, a lot of times he keeps my spirits up just by how crazy he is or how funny he is. Like in the case of our third ever backpacking endeavor, I was kind of ready to pack it up after the first hike didn't work. And she was the one that wanted us to throw our packs on and actually go and find a campsite to stay at. So sometimes you can be surprised, and they will lift your spirits more so than you need to lift theirs. Be that as it may, it's still better to try to keep your own attitude positive so that you can pass that along to them and all just have a fantastic time out in the backcountry. So hey, that's all I got for my 7 tips for backpacking with the kiddos. Hope it was helpful for somebody out there. And hey, you all have a great day.